हेलो सर। सर कैन यू प्लीज ट्राई टू टेक द मीटिंग और मीट गूगल मीट फ्रॉम फर्दर।
गूगल मीट
यस गूगल मीट। एक्चुअली व्हाट हैपेंस इन जूम, इवन इफ द नेट कनेक्शन इज नॉट स्ट्रॉन्ग द वॉइस विल ब्रेक, बट इन द मीट इट डजंट हैपन दैट। So can you please try afterwards, after this meet?
So now I should start Google Meet or from next time?
From next time, sir. No problem. From next
time.
Yesterday,
have you attended the lecture?
Yesterday, yes, sir.
So was there any problem?
Yes, sir. Your voice breaks in intervals of 10 or 15 minutes. So. There's some problem.
Okay, but say what's your good name, beta?
Gaurav, sir.
Gaurav, in Zoom we can interact with students very easily as compared to what Gmeet. In Gmeet there is a one-way interaction. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Today, if you are facing any problem, now let me know. Then I will shift Google Meet from next lecture. Okay.
Okay.
Because now it will take time, na, to arrange the Google Meet. Again, we have to share the link. Okay.
No, that's why I said that after this lecture, from now onwards, we will get to meet.
Okay. So I am requesting you please sit with one register and pen. By doing that you can prepare a sort of notes. Nikhil, yesterday my voice was breaking, Nikhil. Okay, so from next lecture, I will set a link on Google Meet. Okay. Let's see, today I have Wi-Fi for 2 days. Chaitanya, please off your screen. For 2 days, I was using JioNet. So maybe due to the network, due to the low bandwidth of Jio, there might be a problem of voice, but I think today we will not face it. So now you have what experience both I think software Zoom and Google Meet, which is more comfortable for you? All of you, which is more comfortable for you, Google Meet or the Zoom? Google Meet. So everybody is enjoying Google Meet. Gmeet. Okay. But what I think in Google Meet, there is no interaction. If you want to do what message, then you have to come out of the screen. Then you have to message, you have to check the what your response, and then you have to share the screen. That is a problem with Gmeet. Okay, from next time I will now use only Google Meet. Okay. So now we will start the session. Yesterday, what we have seen? We have seen the one-dimensional steady state conduction equation for what? How to calculate one-dimensional steady state conduction equation for the what slab? Rectangular slab. Okay. So for the, again I am repeating, we have taken one slab whose temperature at one surface is T1, at other surface T2, and there due to the temperature difference between two slab, the heat is transferred. Okay, then what we have done, we have considered very small strip which is at a distance of dx. Okay, and the temperature change for this small strip was dT. Then we have first applied the Fourier's law for this red small strip. That is what Q minus Ka dT by dx. Now we want heat transfer for whole the length. Here with the thickness was suppose dx. Now we want the heat transfer for x. So when, therefore, we have integrated it, so when the distance is 0, the temperature was T1. When the distance is x, the temperature was T2, and we have integrated. So we got this equation. Okay, so this equation is for infinite slab. Likewise, we have seen the equation for hollow cylinder. Okay, now in hollow cylinder, what we have done? Again, we have considered the inner surface is at temperature T1, outer one is at T2. Okay, inner radius is Ri and outer radius is Ro, and because T1 is greater than T2, heat transfer takes place from inner to outward. Okay, again here what we have done, we have considered very small strip of thickness dr and the temperature change to that small strip of thickness dr is dt. Then we have applied the Fourier's law for this small strip. It is q minus ka dt by DR. So this is for small strip. Then we have replace the area. What is surface area of cylinder? 2 pi RL. So therefore I replace here by 2 pi RL. Now this is a Fourier's law for small strip. What about now when the thickness is what? RO minus RI. Understood. So therefore now we have integrated it. Okay. So from RI to RO, at RI temperature is T1, at RO temperature is T2. And we got this equation. Understood. So this we have done yesterday itself. This was just a one kind of revision. Now, any problem in this? Now please make a notes parallelly, please make a notes. Okay, it is very helpful for you because in heat transfer there is no theoretical subject. It is a 60% mathematical means 60% mathematical means what? 30% derivation, 30% numerical, and only 40% is theory there. Okay, so now we will consider a heat transfer to hollow sphere. Okay, so again we will consider the same thing for a hollow sphere. What we will do? Okay, hollow sphere. So this is a hollow sphere. The inner temperature is Ti. The outer temperature is TO, inner radius is RI, outer radius is RO. Okay, due to the temperature difference between TI and TO, TI is greater than TO, heat transfer will take place from inner side to outer side, radially outward heat transfer will take place. Now we want to calculate the heat transfer rate. We want to calculate the heat transfer rate through this hollow sphere. For that, what we will do, we will consider a small strip. Here also, we will consider a small strip of thickness, suppose dr, and the distance of that small strip, okay, is r. Radius of the small t is what? R. Understood? So first apply the Fourier's law for that small strip of thickness dr, which is having the temperature gradient dt. So Q is equal to minus Ka dt by dr. This is a what? Heat transfer or a Fourier law for the small strip dr. Okay. Now what is the surface area for sphere? What is the surface area for sphere? It is 4 pi r square. Surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. So therefore, I am replacing the area by 4 pi r square. Okay. Now, after rearranging the things, what I will get? Q divided by R square into dr is equal to minus K 4 pi dt. This is just rearranging the terms. Okay. This is a heat transfer rate for a small strip of thickness dr. Of a small thickness dr. Okay, now we want the heat transfer rate throughout the cylinder. We want heat transfer rate throughout the hollow sphere. Okay, from RI to RO. We want now heat transfer from RI to RO. So what we will do, we will just integrate. We will just integrate from RI to RO and from TI to TO. Okay. So here I have integrated from RI to RO dr by r square is equal to minus 4 pi. It is from TI to TO. At RI temperature is TI and at RO temperature is TO into dt. Okay. Now what is the integration of 1 pi r square? So what is the integration? It is a minus 1 by r q into minus 1 by r. And what is limit? RI to RO is equal to minus 4 pi t. Integration of dt is t, TI to TO. Understood? Please copy this one. Copy means first get it understood, then write it down. Don't copy it like a clerk. Clerk is a job where you are doing the work without understanding. You are just following the procedure. Here you need not to follow procedure. You are an engineer. First get it understood and then copy it. Am I audible? No problem with voice. Gaurav? Gaurav? Are you there, Gaurav? Thank you, Gaurav. So have you written, have you copied this thing? Now put down the limits and tell me the answer. I want answer. I want Q. What will be the Q? I want answer. What will be the Q? Heat transfer to sphere, hollow sphere. Again, I am telling those who have joined late, there is a hollow sphere, inner diameter RI and outer diameter RO. Okay, TI is the inner temperature and TO is the outer temperature. TI is greater than TO, therefore heat transfer takes place. We want to calculate this heat transfer. For that, what we have done, we have considered a small strip, okay, of thickness dr. Here, the temperature change in this small strip is dt. And this small strip dr is at a radius r from center. So this is a Fourier law for that small strip. Q is equal to minus k dt by dr. We have replaced the area by 4 pi r square. This is the surface area of sphere. Then after replacing this, we have get this equation. This is again for the small sphere. Then now we want for, not for small strip, we want for whole sphere. Therefore, we have taken the integration and the limit was from RI to RO. So at RI, temperature is TI. And at RO temperature is TO. So we will get this one. Now I want final answer. Gaurav, okay. Gaurav, there is no log, na? Gaurav, there is no log. dr by r square 1 by r square integration of 1 by r square into dr is minus 1 by r na. Try to solve this one. Don't copy the things. Be active. So here, this is the what Q minus 1 by R limit from Ri to Ro minus 4 pi K. T limit Ti from To. So Q 1 by Ro, okay, minus 1 by Ri. Is equal to minus 4 pi To minus Ti. Mihir, LHS should be different. Okay. Yeah, yeah. I realize what happened. Now it's okay. So this is a heat transfer through sphere, hollow sphere. Okay. So now we have seen the heat transfer through three geometries. First one is rectangular slab, second one is hollow cylinder, and third one is hollow sphere. Understood? Any question? Yes, thank you, Yash. Elton, why you are so late? You have joined after 15 minutes. Elton, not 15 minutes, yeah, 15 minutes. Why you are so late? So now we will move towards the next concept, which is very important. Now please for next 10 minutes, okay, please listen very carefully. We are going to understand very important concept, which is the most important part of the conduction or first chapter. Okay, that is what electrical analogy. How we can compare heat transfer to the electrical analogy. Okay. Means I told you yesterday, heat transfer is equal to what? Current transfer, na? There is no difference because both takes place in a solid due to the exchange of electron amongst the molecule. So here, if you see in electrical, the current flows. So why current flows? Because there is a potential difference, and there is a at two points. If you consider these two points, the potential due to the potential difference, what flows? Current flows. Okay, and in heat transfer, what flows? Heat flows, and there is a heat transfer. Why there is heat transfer? Because of temperature difference, there is a heat transfer. So temperature is here T2, temperature here is T1. Because of this difference in temperature, the heat flow takes place. So why current flows? Current flows due to the potential difference, and heat flows due to the temperature difference. So if you take the current is equal to heat, current flow is equal to heat flow, and what is this one? The potential difference is equal to what? The temperature difference. Understood? Okay, again I am repeating, if you take the example of electrical analogy, current always flows because of potential difference between the two points. And here heat flows because of temperature difference between two surface or two points. So therefore we can see current is equal to heat, means I is equal to Q, and potential difference is nothing but temperature difference. So delta V is equal to delta T. So this is what similarity between electrical and heat flow. Understood? Now, this electrical analogy is very helpful to solve the problems. Electrical analogy is very helpful to solve the problems. So in electrical energy, what flows? Current flows due to the electrons. And in heat flow, what flow? Heat flows due to the motion of electrons and due to the lattice vibration. Okay, so driving potential, what drives the current? It is a potential difference or voltage difference, na, between the two points. And here, because of temperature difference, okay, there is a what transfer of heat. So what flows? What flows here in electrical? Current flows. And here what flows? Heat transfer rate, Q flows. So resistance to flow can be calculated by this rho AL of conductor, and thermal resistance, this is all R. Okay, this now we need to be calculated. Okay, understood. So because of voltage difference or potential difference between two point current flows, and because of temperature difference between two point heat flows. So current is equal to heat, and potential difference is equal to What? Temperature difference. Understood? Just remember this one. Again, I am telling you, just remember this one. Remember this one. Annotated text. Here, the current is equal to heat flow. Okay, and the potential difference, which is also called as voltage difference, is equal to what? Temperature difference. Understood? Okay. So, what is the Ohm's law? V is equal to I R. Okay. V is equal to I R. V is equal to I R. Now we are going to use this. Okay. Please copy this one. You will not find this in any book. Please copy this one. I am requesting you, please sit with register and pen and simultaneously please make your notes. That will be very good. Mihir Kulkarni, why does heat always flows from higher temperature to lower temperature? Mihir, energy always flows from higher to lower temperature, na? If you consider heat is the energy, energy always flows from what? Higher to lower. If you consider the what? The waterfall, dabdaba. It is always fall from at some height h to ground, because when water is at height h from ground level, it has some energy due to the height h. Water has some energy, and that energy is what? Potential energy. Okay, and therefore when water is lifted from the ground, it possesses some energy. That is potential energy. And therefore, water fall from what? At some height to the what? Ground level. So again, water always flows from what? High level to low level. So energy always transfer from high level to low level. And heat is always transferred from high temperature to low temperature. Heat can be transferred from lower temperature to higher temperature. This is a what? Carnot principle, na? Carnot theorem. Heat always flows from higher temperature to lower temperature, but heat can be transferred from lower temperature to higher temperature, but for you have to provide some work. For that, you have to provide some work. The classic example of heat transferring from lower temperature to higher temperature, okay, is a refrigerator, refrigeration system. In that, we are transferring a heat from lower temperature to higher temperature. Mir, am I clear? Am I clear, Mir? Have you understood the example of refrigerator? In refrigerator, we can transfer heat from what? So now, we will take was conductive resistance. Now, how to calculate the conductive resistance by using electrical analogy? So, if you see now, this is a one rectangular slab, okay, with a temperature difference delta T, T1 to T2, thermal conductivity K, delta H is a thickness. So, what will be the Fourier's law, Q is equal to K A delta T by delta X. Understood? Now, I can rearrange this. Q is equal to delta T by delta X K A. Okay. Now, compare this delta T by delta X with delta V by R, and Q is equal to R. Okay. Now compare these two equations. Where is annotation? So if Q is equal to I, means heat is equal to current, and if delta T or change in temperature is equal to change in potential difference or dV, understood? Okay, then this resistance is equal to what? This term, delta X by Ka. Therefore, the resistance, conductive resistance, is equal to what? Delta X by Ka. And now we can see Q is equal to delta T by R, where R is the conductive resistance. We are seeing the heat transfer to conduction. Understood? Again, I am repeating. Q is equal to, this should be minus K. Okay. Forget it. Forget about the sign. Okay. No need to remember sign. Q is equal to K dT by dx. Okay. So, delta T is what? This equal to delta V. Potential difference is equal to what? Temperature difference. Understood? Now compare this equation, that is Q is equal to, with this one. So Q is equal to I, delta V is equal to delta T. What about this one then? Then this equal to delta X by K is equal to what? R. Therefore, R is equal to delta X by Ka. So, Q is equal to delta T by R. Okay, so from this formula also, we can calculate now heat transfer. That is what? Q is equal to delta T by R. Understood? Understood any problem in this one? How R is equal to delta X by Ka, we have compared with Ohm's law, that is I is equal to V by R. Anyone who have not understood? Ajinkya Shinde, Ajinkya Vankhede, अक्षता मोहिते, अक्षय भापकर, अरुण कुंडले, अथर्व अवंती, चैतन्य मोरे, चेतन टोटे, आर यू देयर? चेतन टोटे, व्हाई यू आर नॉट एक्टिव? यस्टरडे आल्सो यू आर नॉट एक्टिव. Then Eltas, have you understood? Gauri Tavare, Guru Prasad, Harsh, are you there or you are watching TV? This is very important. Who is JCS? JCS, are you there? Apurva? Omkar Adhav, have you understood Fourier's law? Omkar, have you understood Fourier's law? So have you understood heat is equal to current and potential difference is equal to temperature difference, Omkar? So here Q is equal to Ka delta T by delta X. Now if you rearrange the things, what you will get, Q is equal to, okay, 1 minute. So you will get Q is equal to delta T by what? Delta X by Ka. We have rearranged the things. This Ka we have taken here. Okay, we have taken here. So Q is equal to delta T by delta X Ka. Now if you compare, okay, I equal to Q. And delta V equal to delta T, delta V is equal to delta T. Then what about R? Here R is a resistance. So R will be equal to delta X by Ka. And this is here what? This is a resistance. So here it will be called as conductive resistance is equal to delta X by Ka. And therefore we can write down Q is equal to delta E and replace this by what? R, nothing else. Okay, understood, Omkar? Omkar Adhav, have you understood? Okay, thank you. Nikhil Ahire, any problem? Gaurav Gaikwad, I can now recollect the names. Ajinkya Shinde, what about others? Okay, leave it. So now this is our conductive resistance. Okay. Then suppose this is a rectangular plate at temperature T2, okay, and this is a suppose air at temperature T infinity, and T2 will be greater than what? T infinity. Understood? So what will happen? T2 is greater than T infinity, therefore there will be a heat transfer Q, okay, from the rectangular surface which at temperature T2 to the air, because air is at a lower temperature. Now this is a which type of heat transfer? This is a which type of heat transfer? Again, I am repeating, there is a air at temperature T infinity, okay, and there is the rectangular face which at temperature T2 is greater than T infinity. So air is in contact with rectangular surface. Okay, so heat will transfer from rectangular surface to air. So which type of heat transfer is this one? Which type of heat transfer is this one? Soumya, how it is a radiation? How it will be radiation? Air is flowing over surface. Air is flowing over surface. Air is in motion. There is a medium. Air has a motion. Air is not still. So the heat transfer between the air and the surface of the rectangular plate, that will be convection, because air is moving relative to the solid surface. Understood? So what will be the heat transfer formula? What will be the heat transfer rate formula for convection? Apurva, can you tell me, Apurva Kalband, please write down the formula for heat transfer rate. Apurva, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What will be the heat transfer rate formula? Have you understood what I am telling?
Yes, sir.
Okay, there is a air at temperature T infinity, okay, which is in contact with the rectangular surface, which is at temperature T2, and air is flowing over this surface. Okay, so there will be convection.
Yes.
So what is the formula for heat transfer rate? Yesterday, yes, we have seen Nikhil Ahire. This is not a conduction. We are talking about convection. Air has a motion. In conduction, there is no motion. Neeraj, Rudrani, you are very much correct. But I am expecting an answer from Kalban, Kayala, Alaka.
एक मिनट.
Convection काढा, तुम्ही का लिहिलं काही? Notes काढल्या?
हो सर, काढलं.
हा, ते बघा convection चा formula. अक्षता मोहिते. अक्षता मोहिते. अक्षय भापकर, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मुला, टेल मी फॉर कन्वेक्शन. अपूर्व असू द्या, बघा मी सांगतो तुम्हाला आता, ठीक आहे? This is the air. Air is flowing over the surface with temperature T2. Okay, with temperature T2. With temperature T2, air is flowing and T2 is higher than T infinity. Okay. So whenever any fluid is flowing over a surface, there is a convection. So what is the formula for convection? It is simply QHA, na? Surface temperature minus fluid temperature. So what is surface temperature? T2. And what is fluid temperature? Infinity. That's all. This is a convective formula, na? This is the formula for convection. Q is equal to HA T2 minus T1, Newton's law of cooling, where H is a heat transfer coefficient. Ajinkya Vankhede, have you understood? Jainil, have understood? Sanket Solanke, are you there? Sanket Solanke,
yes sir.
Have understood?
Yes sir.
Okay, now we have to find out convective resistance. Now what we have found out before this one? Conductive resistance. Now we are interested in convective resistance. Okay, so if you see, that will be T2 minus T1. T2 minus T infinity is nothing but what? This is not equal to, that is the annotation from Zoom. Let me erase that one. So here, HA T2 minus T1, this is what? Convection heat transfer. T2 minus T infinity is nothing but delta T. Okay, and 1 by HA. We have just rearranged the things. It is 1 by HA. So delta T divided by R. What is R? R is a convective resistance. Understood? We are comparing with I is equal to delta V by R. Okay. So after rearranging the things, here you get delta T means Q is equal to I. Q is equal to I. Delta T is equal to delta V. But what about 1 by HA? 1 by HA is equal to now R. Understood? And R is nothing but convective resistance. R is equal to 1 by HA. 1 by HA is a convective resistance. Understood? Omkar Adhav, have you understood now? This time, Ritvik, why are you so late? Anyone who has not understood, please let me know. I am here to make a thing easier for you. Okay, so if you are not understanding anything, let me know. Swarali Deshpande, have you understood? Chetan, have you understood conductive resistance? So beta, here what we have doing, we have taking the problem of conduction. Okay, let me erase all these things, then I will explain once again. I think you have a problem of network issue, therefore you might have not understood this. So Chetan, this is the air which is flowing over the, this is the air which is flowing over the one rectangular face with temperature T2, and T2 is greater than T infinity. So therefore there will be heat transfer from rectangular face to the what? Air, moving air. So because it is a moving air, this is the problem of what? Convection. So now what is the heat transfer rate from convection? Yesterday we have seen Q is equal to HA, solid temperature T2, fluid temperature T infinity. Understood? Now suppose I rearrange the things, Q is equal to delta T, T2 minus T infinity, nothing but temperature difference, na? Delta T divided by 1 by HA. Okay, now this equation, suppose this equation, if I compare with Ohm's law, that is I is equal to delta V by R. Now compare these two equations. So Q is equal to I, delta V by delta T is equal to delta V, and 1 by HA, this is nothing but R, and this R is called as convective resistance 1 by HA. Understood? Okay, Guru Prasad, no tension, no problem. Yesterday I also was facing the same problem. Okay, have you written these things? Soumya Chafle, have you understood? Vishal Tambare, Abhishek Todkar, Tanish Yadav, Siddhi Dhere, Shreyas Dambure, Rudrani Patil, Rohit Savan, Pradyumna Jadav, JCS, who is JCS? Can you tell me your name? JCS. Nikhil, can you tell me the name of JCS? Nikhil Ahire. Who is JCS?
Hello.
Hello.
Suyesh Amrutkar, sir, roll number 3, sir. Laptop se open
kiya. Suyesh Amrutkar. So please write down your name, beta. This is very good for identifying. Okay. So are you understanding?
Sir, Dipad. Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Thank you. Then Harshal Madi, Gauri Tavare, Chinmay. So I have to take the roll call whether you have understood or not. Okay. Now we will apply the electrical analogy to what? To the hollow cylinder. To the hollow cylinder. So please apply it and tell me what is R. You know the heat transfer rate for hollow cylinder. You know heat transfer rate for hollow cylinder. I want the value of R. I want the value of R. You know heat transfer rate for hollow cylinder. We just yesterday we have derived Q is equal to what is the value. So tell me the value of R. Who is the first? I will give him 100 rupees by Paytm or Google Pay. Mihir, you will get 100 rupees. Mihir, you will get 100 rupees. No, I will transfer it, Mir. That is a sort of recognition and appreciation. So the Q formula yesterday we have seen it is 2 pi LK T1 minus T2 divided by RI by RO. Okay. So I have rearranged the things. Q is equal to delta T. Okay. Just you have to keep delta T on this side. Okay. And in denominator, what you will get ln RO by RA 2 pi LK. Okay. And now you have to compare that is Q is equal to delta divided by I thermal. So I thermal, R thermal is equal to what? Ln RO by RI divided by 2 pi LK. This is for electric what cylinder, hollow cylinder. Understood? Any problem? Any problem? Now for sphere, for hollow sphere, for hollow sphere, what will be the formula? Yes, Kolti, you are correct. You know heat transfer rate for now sphere, hollow sphere, sorry. So just 10 minutes ago, we have calculated the Q is equal to 4 pi KL delta T. So I have taken that in denominator. So 1 by 4 pi K delta T 1 divided by R O minus R I. So finally, you will get so for sphere, Q is equal to 4 pi k delta T by this one, 1 minus Ri by Ro. I have taken 1 by 4 pi k 0 here. So now compare this Q delta T by this one. Okay. So if you take Ro minus Ri divided by 4 pi k Ro Ri, this is what resistance in sphere. Chetan, this is now purely conduction for cylinder and for sphere. This is a purely conduction. I have not considered air. I have not considered air here. In this is a conduction because we are considering the heat transfer from inner surface to outer surface within the solid, within the sphere. Okay, we are not considering the air here outside or inside. What we are considering, the heat transfer Q from inner surface to outer surface due to temperature difference within a solid. Okay, so it's a conduction. Any question, please, any doubt, please get it clear. Nikhil, any doubt? Parth, why you have joined so late? So what we have done, we have find out the heat conduction equation for rectangular slab, for hollow cylinder and for hollow sphere. Then we have understand the what is the similarity between electrical transfer or current transfer and the heat transfer by electrical analogy, and that electrical analogy is very helpful to find out the resistance, that is conductive resistance and convective resistance. So we have find out the conductive resistance in again slab, hollow cylinder and hollow sphere. Okay, now we will stop here. Please put your name and roll number in chat box, that will be considered as a attendance. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Please make a revision. If you have a time, please make a revision what we have done till now.